Sure, you come for Danny and Chris, but you stay to watch these fools.
Welcome back to our channel. You know, the greatest YouTube channel in all of the land. Danny and Chris, Chris and Danny. We are going to go ahead and react to Logic, Dad Bod. Now, Logic recently put out what he's claiming to be his last album. Mm-hmm. How does that make you feel?
I think it's a lie.
I hope it is. Her and I are actually significant fans of Logic. We've been to plenty of concerts. Mm-hmm. We've been fucking with him like nonstop. Danny, well, me too. I guess we both kind of don't agree with what happened with Jessica Andrea, and that's none of our business. Mm-hmm. But it's kind of played. So we're here for the music and only the music. We don't really support the dude outside of his music. So. Dad Bod off of the new album, No Pressure, which is kind of cool. I'm happy that if he is going to go out, at least he gave us a follow-up to Under Pressure.
Right.
But we'll see how it sounds. Let's go.
Okay.
Oh, hit that subscribe button. Mm.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm retiring.
The homies at the crib, bumping Pac Div. This the life I live, you ain't nobody. Hit the studio with no ID, make a couple platinum records in that bitch, and then I dip about it. On the 101, my wife text me, talking about you gotta get home, feed your son, girl, don't trip about it. Walk up in with applesauce and broccoli, little Bobby better eat your greens, boy, don't give me lip about it. I'm a dad, this my life, this the type of shit I write. I was hungry in the basement, now that boy, he full of life. Smoking dope as a kite, only when that babysitter at the crib, though. Take my shorty to Noble and dig up in a rear, though.
Take my shorty to Noble and dig up in a rear, though, yeah.
Cause back in my day, it was food stamps. And I love my wife like I am Chance. I bet you rap about the shit me and him rap about if you...
That was actually pretty good. I love my wife like I am Chance. I bet you rap about the Chance the Rap. That was pretty clear. All right. Now, everybody knows Logic struggle. He came from HUD homes. He came from Section 8. And, you know, just a really rough upbringing. So I can't hate on him wanting to give a better life to his child.
Right.
And if music was the thing that got him there, whatever, man. You can't hate on the dude for wanting to retire. I feel like all he ever wanted was to... I think all he ever wanted to be was a dad. It seems like that's pretty evident. That's all he seemed to care about.
Cause back in my day, it was food stamps. And I love my wife like I am Chance. I bet you rap about the shit me and him rap about if you had ever made it out, but you ain't never had a chance.
Cocky motherfucker.
Mm-hmm.
Way of life, my decisions, I made them right. Chilling with the homies at the crib, bumping Pac Div. This the life I live, you ain't nobody. Hit the studio with no ID, make a couple platinum records in that bitch, and then I dip about it. On the 101, my wife text me, talking about you gotta get home, feed your son, girl, don't trip about it. Walk up in with applesauce and broccoli, little Bobby better eat your greens, boy, don't give me lip about it.
I've upgraded, why they waited, will they love it, will they...
God, I love that. I've upgraded, why they waited? All right, that was a nice little throwback.
Then we're applesauce and broccoli, little Bobby better eat your greens, boy, don't give me lip about it.
I've upgraded, why they waited, will they love it, will they hate it, who gives a fuck, though?
Rappers praying they next, this shit is cutthroat. I'm living on another planet, my manic depression make me constantly want to panic.
There's a little bit of feedback if you guys heard that.
Sorry.
I apologize. Yeah, we're definitely going to have to get a new fucking interface.
Yeah.
Before that happened, he said something about rappers praying that they next, this shit is cutthroat. Mm-hmm. And you could take it as praying, you know, that cutthroat at their necks.
Mm-hmm.
So, I don't know. Boy, don't he always played this word.
Why they waited, will they love it, will they hate it, who gives a fuck, though? Rappers praying they next, this shit is cutthroat. I'm living on another planet, my manic depression make me constantly want to panic. I'm stressing on stage, pretending everybody undressing. I think I'll never learn my lesson. Fuck it all. Hey, yo, I'm on that lyrical, poetic, rhetoric, lyrical, miracle, satirical shit. If you don't like my conscious rap, you won't like my material shit. Love them or hate them, everybody, no logic can spit.
That was dope. If you don't like my conscious rap, you're going to fucking hate my material shit. And, yo, man, he earned it. He earned a rap about the material shit. I kind of feel like he gave a little shout out to rhetoric there. He said, you know, rhetoric is this word that everybody uses. Mm-hmm. Well, not really everybody. But he, listen to what he says about his lyrics or rhetoric.
I'm living on another planet. My manic depression make me constantly want to panic. I'm stressing on stage, pretending everybody undressing. I think I'll never learn my lesson. Fuck it all. Hey, yo, I'm on that lyrical, poetic, rhetoric, lyrical, miracle, satirical shit. If you don't like my conscious rap, you won't like my material shit. Love them or hate them, everybody know logic is spit. Used to be up to date on that rap political shit. But nowadays I'm up to my elbows in every single inch of my body and my baby shit. I can tell you more about diapers than modern rappers and ciphers. I used to be about to be rabbits and Mekhi Phifers. Hit the stage, grip the mic, and murder you like a pro-lifer. But I'm done now. I got a son now. Fuck the rap game. I'm done now. Chilling with the...
He wants to focus on his son.
I cannot hate it, dude. I really... I respect the hustle. The dude fucking came from nothing.
Homies at the crib, bumping Pac Div. This the life I live, you ain't nobody.
And he ain't trying to focus on all that stress no more.
Make a couple platinum records in that bitch and then I dip about it. On the 101, my wife text me, talking about you gotta get home, feed your son, girl, don't trip about it. Walk up in with applesauce and broccoli. Little Bobby better eat your greens, boy, don't give me lip about it. They say that that boy done changed. He don't rap about his everyday life, he ain't the same, goddamn.
He is, though. He is rapping about his everyday life. I mean, you get money. Things change.
I already had a hard life once. Am I supposed to recreate it every album for you cunts? Okay, you want to hear about my everyday...
Dude, I got to give it. Dude, this song is hard. He is like, he's going in. And he's not, he's like, I
unapologetic.
I've used it a lot today, but he's very unapologetic about it.
Everyday life, he ain't the same. Goddamn, already had a hard life once. Am I supposed to recreate it every album for you cunts? Okay, you want to hear about my everyday? I wake up, I wake my son up, then I feed him and lead him into his car seat. Drive up the street down to Target. Don't do hard drugs or beat my wife, but the paparazzi still wanna start shit. I don't answer their questions, I leave them in the dark, bitch. Then I walk through the automatic doors. A couple fans spot me, but shit, I ain't on tour. I ain't trying to ignore, but I head to aisle 4 cause my drawers stink as fuck and I need some new drawers. Then I spot some more fans staying hella hardcore. Ask me for a pic and I say sure. Scratch my dick and shake his hand. Shaking uncontrollably, he tells me I'm the man. Now I'm headed to aisle 3 for some Bounty paper towels. I also grab some wet wipes to clean the shit from my bowels. A really hot girl walks by with a fat ass, but I'm just wondering if Hefty really holds the most trash. Forgot my card at home, thank God I brought some cash. Then I grab some preparation H for the critics up my...
You see that? Fuck Donald Trump.
Yeah.
That was dope. Dude, I actually like how he's giving you a rundown of his everyday life.
Yeah, his everyday life.
Yeah, this is what you wanted. This is what you get.
Ass, but I'm just wondering if Hefty really holds the most trash. Forgot my card at home. Thank God I brought some cash. Then I grabbed some preparation H for the critics up my ass. Head to aisle 5 for some Sergeant Smash cereal. Is this what you wanted? Everyday life material? I'm not a kid anymore. Be sure shit's boring. Made it out the basement. Now my bank account soaring. Most exciting part of my
That's
life
dope.
Is probably touring. Don't get me wrong. I love fans in every single city, but hotels suck and the internet is shitty. I mean, why rap about everyday shit when I can murder punchlines and sound dope like this? Chilling with the homies.
This dude is, I can't even be mad. Retire, man, enjoy it.
Hit the studio with no ID, make a couple platinum records in that bitch and then I dip about it. On the 101, my wife text me, talking about you gotta get home, feed your son, girl, don't trip about it. Walk up in with applesauce and broccoli, little Bobby better eat your greens, boy, don't get me lip about it.
Boy, she just happened to be working at the right nicotine shop. You know what, man? I mean, that's what's up, though. I respect it. I won't hate on his personal life.
Mm-mm.
But you got it. You got to wonder, does Hefty really hold the most trash?
I don't know.
I mean, I'm kind of curious now. We're probably going to have to go experiment with this. That was Logic's dad bod, and...
I don't hate it.
Nah, man. I respect anybody who worked their fucking ass off to get what the fuck they have. And you don't owe us nothing, dude.
Mm-mm.
You go live in that, you know, retirement life. That's cool.
Yeah.
And don't be envious or jealous, motherfuckers. Work your ass off and get the same thing. Peace.
Bye.